Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to Miss Elaine's Book Nook. It's been a long time since we've been together, hasn't it? I've missed you, and I'm so glad we're back together again. Here in Miss Elaine's Book Nook, in our story time room today, do you notice anything that's different? And I'm not talking about Mr. Bear. I know sometimes he's here and sometimes he's not. There's something else different about my Book Nook today. What is it? I think one of you said it. Yeah, I have all the books turned backward. Why would I do that? That's because, boys and girls, I want you to guess what story time is going to be about today. So are you ready? Do you have your thinking caps on? Okay, I'm going to give you 5 clues, and I want to see if you can guess today's story time theme. Okay, boys and girls, as I give you the clues, I'm also going to be cutting this brown piece of construction paper. So this is actually going to act like a clue too. So you'll listen to my clues and you'll look at this bonus clue, and I have a feeling you're going to guess what it is. Okay, clue number 1. I can be both sweet and spicy at the same time. Sweet and spicy. And there's your first picture clue. I smell so good when I come out of the oven. What would smell yummy for the tummy? Clue number 3, I can be fancy or plain. Fancy or plain. Here's a little bit more of your picture clue. Do you know what else? There's a famous story all about me. Do we know a famous story about somebody who came out of the oven smelling yummy and sweet? Here's your final clue, boys and girls. When he came out of the oven, he started yelling, "Run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man." So today's story time, boys and girls, is all about gingerbread. If you wanted to make a little guy like this at home, you certainly could. You can give it 2 eyes. And if we were making one, maybe those would be chocolate chips. Maybe a raisin nose and a raisin mouth. So we're just using a black marker and adding some dots to his face. What else does he need? Oh, maybe some buttons. If we were going to eat him, what could the buttons be? Big chunks of something, huh? You have any ideas? And sometimes when you see a gingerbread boy or girl, you can see squiggly lines of icing for the hands and the feet. So now we're just taking our black marker and we're making squiggly lines. There you go. You can easily make one of these guys at home too. So let's get ready to listen to our first gingerbread man story. We're going to start with a classic tale, boys and girls, one that you already might be familiar with. This one is retold by Eric Kimmel, but it's the story of the gingerbread man. Once upon a time, an old woman and an old man decided to make some gingerbread. First, they mixed up the dough. Then, they rolled it out on the table. Then, they cut the dough into the shape of a gingerbread man. The old woman and the old man put the gingerbread man in the oven to bake. He baked for a good long time. When he was done, the old man and the old woman let him cool a little while. Then they decorated him with 2 licorice eyes, a mouth made of icing, and 3 peppermint buttons down the front of his shirt. As soon as they put on the last peppermint button, up jumped the little gingerbread man. And to their surprise, he leapt off the table and ran out the door. "Come back, gingerbread man! Come back!" the old woman and the old man called as they ran after him. "Get back here!" You believe it? The cookie came to life? He jumped off the table and ran out the door? But the gingerbread man ran faster than the old man and the old woman, and he said, "I'll run and I'll run as fast as I can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man." Down the road ran the gingerbread man. He ran past the pigsty where the old sow lay. "Slow down, gingerbread man. I want to talk to you," the old sow oinked. and as she started running after the gingerbread man. But the gingerbread man ran faster. "I'll run and run as fast as I can. You won't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man. I ran from the woman, I ran from the man, and I'll run from you. See if I can." Down the road, the gingerbread man ran. He ran past the dog house. The dog wagged his tail. "Slow down, gingerbread man. I want to talk to you," the dog barked, and he started running after the gingerbread man. But the gingerbread man ran faster, and he said, "I'll run and I'll run as fast as I can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man. I ran from the woman. I ran from the man. I'll run from you. See if I can." Down the road ran the gingerbread man. He ran past the pasture where the horse and the cow stood grazing. The horse neighed. The cow mooed. "Slow down, gingerbread man. We want to talk to you." And they started running after the gingerbread man. But the gingerbread man ran faster, and he said, "I'll run and I'll run as fast as I can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man. I ran from the woman, I ran from the man, and I'll run from you. Just see if I can." Down the road ran the gingerbread man with the horse and the cow, the dog and the sow, the old woman and the old man running behind him. Are they going to catch up? Are they going to grab him? Or is he going to get away? The gingerbread man ran and ran until he came to the river. There he stopped, wondering what to do. "Hello, gingerbread man," a voice said. Who was it? The sly old fox. It was the fox, and the gingerbread man cried, "I'll run and I'll run as fast as I can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man. I ran from the horse, I ran from the cow, I ran from the dog, and I ran from the sow. I ran from the woman, and I ran from the man. I'll run from you, too. Just see if I can." And the fox chuckled. "Why, gingerbread man, you don't have to run from me. I am your friend. I want to help you." Should he trust the fox? Does the fox really want to be his friend? I'm not so sure. "How can you help me?" the gingerbread man began to ask the fox. "Well, hop on my tail," the sly fox said. "I will carry you across the river. You will be safe on the other side." So the gingerbread man hopped onto the fox's tail. The fox jumped into the river and started swimming across. Was that a good idea? "Gingerbread man, the water is rising. Hop on my back so your feet don't get wet," the fox called out. So the gingerbread man listened, hopped on the fox's back, and the fox swam on. And after a while, the fox said, "Gingerbread man, the water is still rising. Hop on my head so your feet don't get wet." So the gingerbread man hopped on the fox's head, and the fox swam on. Oh no, if this is a good idea, boys and girls. I'm afraid that fox might be tricking him. After a while, the fox said again, "Gingerbread man, the water is still rising. Hop on my snout so your feet don't get wet." So the gingerbread man hopped on the fox's snout. But no sooner had he done that than the fox threw his head back and snapped up the gingerbread man in one bite. I knew it. But don't be sad, for that wasn't the end of the gingerbread man. The gingerbread man has gone away, but he'll be back again someday. For gingerbread men return, it said, when somebody makes some gingerbread. So there's a whole new batch of gingerbread men. That's the end of the classic tale, The Gingerbread Man. Boys and girls, I found some gingerbread men. I put them here on my cookie sheet. Can you see those? Here's our five gingerbread boys and girls, and here's our rhyme. Five little gingerbread men laying on a tray. One jumped up and ran away, shouting, "Catch me, catch me, catch me if you can. I'm really quick," said the gingerbread man. So now how many are left? Right, four. Four little gingerbread men lying on a tray. One jumped up and ran away, shouting, "Catch me, catch me, catch me if you can. I'm really quick," said the gingerbread man. Now we're down to how many? That's right, three. three little gingerbread men lying on a tray. One jumped up and ran away, saying, "Catch me, catch me, catch me if you can. I'm really quick," said the gingerbread man. Two little gingerbread men lying on a tray. One jumped up and ran away. What did he say? Say it with me at home. He yelled, "Catch me, catch me, catch me if you can. I'm really quick," said the gingerbread man. That leaves one on our tray. One little gingerbread man laying on a tray. He jumped up and ran away. Say it with me, yelling, "Catch me, catch me, catch me if you can. I'm really quick," said the gingerbread man. They're all gone. No more gingerbread men laying on the tray. They all jumped up and ran away. Oh, how I wish they had stayed to play. Next time I'll eat them before they run away. I do love a good gingerbread cookie. Let's put them all back up here on the board. Maybe we'll use them again later. But now, boys and girls, I want to get ready to read you another gingerbread story. This one is called Señorita Gordita. So it's the same idea, where this little gordita is going to run away and is going to be chased by animals, and she's going to keep on running, just like our gingerbread man. But instead of gingerbread, she's a gordita. And a gordita, boys and girls, is a flour tortilla. Maybe you've had one before. And it's usually deep fried, really, really tasty. So Señorita Gordita is Miss Gordita. Araña, which is a spider. Araña wiggled her legs as she set the gordita on a paper towel to drain. "You're one tasty looking gordita. I'm in for a treat." But that gordita hopped up. "Oh no, Araña, I'm one fast gordita. You can't catch me." And with a flip and a skip and a zip, zoom, zip, the gordita raced out the door. "Señorita Gordita, come back," called Araña, chasing after her. There goes the spider, the Araña, chasing the gordita. She's going to get away. But Señorita Gordita zipped through the desert until she came to a bush. Lagarto was resting underneath, and he opened one eye. So you can tell me, boys and girls, what's a lagarto? In Spanish, a lagarto is a lizard. "Hola, Señorita Gordita. Come share my shade," he said. "You look delicious. I mean, hot." Should Gordita listen? Probably not. Look at the lagarto licking his lips. He doesn't want to share the shade with Gordita. He wants to eat her. Señorita Gordita jumped aside. "Oh no, amigo. I ran from Araña so fast I left her spinning. I'll run away from you too. I'm putting the pedal to the metal. Adios, lagarto." And with a flip and a skip and a zip, zoom, zip, off she ran. Lagarto skidded after her. Señorita Gordita sped along until she came to an arroyo. Crotolo slithered up. An arroyo is like a little stream. And a crotolo is what? Me no gusta crotolos. I don't like crotolos. It's a snake. "Buenos dias, Señorita Gordita. Say, you smell scrumptious. Come visit a while." "Buenos dias, Crotolo, but no thanks. I airstreamed Araña and gassed past Lagarto, so keep your fangs to yourself, Crotolo." And with a flip and a skip and a zip, zoom, zip, off she ran. Crotolo slithered after her. After a while, she stopped to rest on the limb of a mesquite tree. A scorpion curled his stinger over his back. "Hola, Señorita Gordita. You look tasty. I mean, lovely. Come a little closer, amiga," he said. "I am rather fine looking, aren't I? But I airstreamed Araña, gassed past Lagarto, and cruised past Crotolo. So put down your zinger of a stinger, Escorpión. You'll never catch me." And with a flip and a skip and a zip, zoom, zip, she left Escorpión in a cloud of dust. Escorpión joined the chase. Who's chasing after her now? Araña, Lagarto, Crotolo, and a scorpion. Señorita Gordita ran on, and after a while she came upon Javelina, who was munching on a prickly pear cactus. Javelina snorted. "Hola, amigo, why the rush? Come join me for a lunch munch." Señorita Gordita shook her head. "No way, Javelina. You might want to lunch munch me, But I airstreamed Aranya, gas past Lagarto, cruise past Crotolo, and dusted Escorpión. And I'll lose you too, amiga. And with a flip and a skip and a zip zoom zip, she hustled away. Javelina joined the chase. Are any of them going to catch her? Or will she get away? Señorita Gordita laughed. I'm zip zoom fast as can be. No desert beast will lunch on me. Soon she came upon a coyote scratching at a ground squirrel burrow. Buenos dias, Señorita Gordita. Come help me dig out this burrow. There's a fat ground squirrel inside. Enough for both of us. Remember, those fox can be sly. What did the fox do in our first story? No, Señor Coyote. You look hungry, amigo. I airstreamed Aranya, gas past Lagarto, cruise past Crotolo, dusted Escorpión, and hustled away from Javelino. And I'll ditch you, too. And with a flip and a skip and a zip zoom zip, Señorita Gordita sped away. Coyote chased behind. Señorita Gordita laughed. I love to run. It's fun, fun, fun. She whizzed along until she came to a tall saguaro, reaching its giant arms up to the sky. So a saguaro, boys and girls, is a cactus. Who goes there? Asked Buho. Me, Señorita Gordita. Buho blinked his big yellow eyes. I see a cloud of dust coming. Are you being chased? Yes, but I'm zip-zoom fast. No one can catch me. They could if you get too tired, said Buho. Jump up here where you can rest safely for a bit. Is Al trying to be a friend? Or is Al trying to eat Gordita too? Señorita Gordita cocked her head. That cloud of dust is a group of critters who want to eat me. Maybe that's what you want. Who, me? Asked Buho. I hunt and eat at night. As you can see, it's daytime. The dust cloud is getting closer. You must get moving, Señorita. Gordita has to make a big decision here. Should she keep on running, or should she hop up on the cactus with Buho, the owl? Señorita Gordita looked at the approaching dust cloud. Buho was right. She did feel tired and hot, and a rest would be good. Buho, she shouted. Buho blinked. Yes? Thanks for your offer. I'll come up for a rest. So Señorita Gordita took a huge leap and landed beside Buho, high on the saguaro. In an instant, Buho grabbed Señorita Gordita in his talons and opened his sharp beak. And soon, there was nothing left of Señorita Gordita except a few crumbs. Being zip-zoom fast is good, Señorita, said Buho. But being smart is better. The owl tricked her, didn't he? He did. And in the back of this, boys and girls, it tells you all of the Spanish terms. So if you wanted to learn them and practice them, you could. Buho was the owl and Araña was the spider. And they're all listed back here, along with a recipe for gorditas. I love when there's recipes in the backs of our books. All right, boys and girls, let's do another gingerbread rhyme. So here they are again, our five yummy gingerbread. Five yummy gingerbread sitting on a plate. And the first one said, oh boy, do we smell great. The second one said, there's a chill in the air. And the third one said, I see hungry children everywhere. The fourth one said, well, I think we better run. And the fifth one said, here the children come. So then the children each grabbed one with a munch, crunch, munch. And the five yummy gingerbread turned into lunch. Nom, 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 nom. Well, boys and girls, let's switch it up a little bit. Let's still read another gingerbread book, but maybe one where he doesn't get eaten in the end. Let's read this story called Ginger Bear. Our story starts with a lump of pastry that Horace's mum gave him, which Horace would usually roll about over the floor and furniture until it was deep gray and fluffy and quite a lot smaller. But today, Horace's mum gave him a cookie cutter in the shape of a bear to use. So Horace stamped out a gingerbread bear and gave it currant eyes and a nose. Horace's mom put it in the oven to bake. 20 minutes later, the cookie bear was golden colored and smelled lovely. And Horace wanted to take a bite, but no, Horace, said Horace's mom. It's too hot. First, you must wait for it to cool down. So an hour later, Horace remembered the cold gingerbread bear and was about to take a bite. But, "No, Horace," said Horace's mom. "You were just about to have dinner. You'll spoil your appetite." So before bedtime, Horace thought of the golden cookie bear and was just gazing at it. But, "No, Horace," said Horace's mom. "You have just cleaned your teeth." So Horace put the bear in a little tin and put it on his pillow. Maybe he'll dream about the gingerbread bear that night. It was the middle of the night and Ginger Bear woke up. He yawned and he stretched and he looked about for somebody to play with. But everybody seemed to be asleep. Ginger Bear had an idea. "I shall make some friends," he said to himself, and he went into the kitchen. So here Ginger Bear comes to life and he sneaks out of Horace's bedroom and he's going down to the kitchen. Gingerbread Bear found butter and flour and milk. He mixed up the mixture and rolled it and shaped it and put it, the first batch of friends, in the oven to bake. When they had cooled, Ginger Bear dressed them in the icing of many colors, thousands of sugar sprinkles, and candied peels and glazed cherries in little silver balls. Oh, I bet you they looked so pretty. "And now," Gingerbread Bear said to his new friends, "let the fun begin." What are they going to do? Look how fancy they all look. I like how he decorated all of them. "Come one, come all, one night only. Ginger Bear Circus is performing in the kitchen. Watch the acrobats as they toss and tumble. Gasp at Strong Bear raises the rolling pin. Scream with surprise as our aeronaut is fired from the ketchup bottle." Oh my goodness. They're having quite the good time. The circus was so exciting that no one noticed the shadow looming in the doorway. What shadow? Who's coming in, boys and girls? Bongo the dog liked cookies, but not in a way that is necessarily good for the cookies. Ginger Bear just managed to clamber to safety. Look, there goes Gingerbread, hopped up on the chair, up onto the counter. Ginger Bear looked sadly at the mess. He suddenly realized that he needed to find a place where a cookie could be safe. When Horace awoke the next morning, he reached for the tin that had contained the little cookie bear, but all he found was crumbs and a card that looked familiar. The life of a cookie is usually short and sweet, but Ginger Bear has found somewhere safe to be. Where's he going? The golden bun. The gingerbread bear is in the pastry shop display. Some of it's cardboard covered in icing, some of it's plaster. It looks delicious, but it can never be eaten. The display changes through the year, but every day Gingerbread Bear is the star. And every night, well, who knows? Do you think he has many more adventures at nighttime like he did at Horace's house? Does he sneak out of that bakery shop for some more fun? Maybe. But at least there he's safe in the bakery shop window where nobody will eat him. He's just on display. I liked that one. Boys and girls, we talked about decorating gingerbread cookies at home, and you can do that with paper and crayons. You can also make a gingerbread house, and our library gingerbread house workshop is coming up, but you can do this anytime at home. I'm going to show you how. Okay, so now, boys and girls, I'm going to teach you how to make your own gingerbread house at home, and what a fun holiday tradition this is to start, or again, fun any time of the year. It's a fun craft, sometimes a little bit messy, so make sure mom or dad or a special grown-up is helping you. But all you need to start with is a carton. So I'm using an empty iced tea carton. You can save a milk carton, an orange juice container, whatever you have. And then you're going to need a can of icing. And the first thing that I like to do is I like to put a little bit of icing on the plate. So you can see what I'm doing. I kind of spread it along the plate. And then I put my container down. That's just to help it stick so it doesn't move anywhere. So when I'm decorating, it kind of stays put, if you will. Okay? So once your carton is then glued to your plate, then you can start putting the icing, the glue, all over the container so that the other things that you want to decorate it with will also stick. So your icing is acting as your glue. I like to cover all the sides And while I'm covering the sides with my icing, well, that's what I'm thinking. What's my gingerbread house gonna look like? What kinds of things am I gonna put on it this time? What kinds of things do I want to use for the roof? See, this is the roof part up here that I'm icing now. And what special things do I want to use for the door? Am I going to make windows? So you have lots of time to think about it while you're icing it. We'll just do it really fast here today. Make sure you cover it completely so your candy and your other items don't fall off. Okay, give it a good coating of icing. Don't be shy. Okay, then once it's all covered, then you're going to want to take some crackers. And I usually use graham crackers. And then you stick the crackers to the house all the way around if you want. You can do the roof too, unless you're going to use something else for the roof. Sometimes you'll have to break the graham crackers in half. That's why I like graham crackers, because they break easily right down the middle, don't they? They sort of have that dotted line for you. Oh, we forgot to ice one side, didn't we? It is fun to lick the knife, but make sure you do that when you're all done. You can eat the leftover stuff when you're all done making your gingerbread masterpiece. You have to be patient. You have to wait till the end. Does smell delicious though. Yummy and sweet. Okay. So once you have crackers all around, your carton is pretty much covered. Well, then you get to add the extras. Then you can add your windows and your doors. So you're going to have to think again what you want to use. You put a little bit more icing. And then you stick your candy. Leftover Halloween candy, boys and girls, is a great thing to use. You can use pasta if you have it at home, pretzels, cereal. I have this container of sprinkles. I'm going to take out some of these little red candies. And oh, maybe I want to stick those over there. I don't know if it's going to be a window or what it's going to be yet, but I kind of like the way that looks right there. And so you can just keep adding and adding and adding. And you want to do that to all the sides and the roof. You can get really creative and maybe make a chimney. And maybe you can put icing all around and make a yard with trees and animals. Whatever you want to do, you can go crazy. That's a very simple way to make a gingerbread house at home. I hope you had a lot of fun today on Missy Lane's Book Nook. I sure did have fun reading stories to you. And I'll see you again very soon next month. Happy holidays.